Hi guys, it's been a while since I did a crafty video, and I've just noticed that the CAC, I think it is, group is doing a hashtag event, and I haven't done one of them in a long time either, so I thought I would give this one a go because it's kind of up my street and I was kind of working on something the last day or so. I did do a video, but then I had to stop it and, you know, just like it in a way, and I can't be bothered trying to edit it and all that kind of stuff, so I'm just going to start again. So I have started it, but I'll show you basically what I'm doing. So I like doing art journal pages on loose paper, and then I usually put them in a binder at the end of it. So basically I got this box and Happy Mail. Well, Happy Mail was in it, should I say. And it was from Nicky Parr. Now this would be easy enough to make yourself out a bit of cardboard. Just get a bit of cardboard. I'm not sure how lengthwise and widthwise, because I don't know if my ruler's big enough to measure it. So, you know, I don't know, but I'll probably be sure it'll be times two, so it's about 9 inches one side, so say about 18 inches probably, I would say, maybe. So obviously my ruler's not going to be big enough. Now, you don't need to keep the flap, obviously, as well, but if you want the flap, it is about, right, so it's 12. So I would say, like, roughly about 21 inches across. And then obviously it's kind of hard to get these measurements because I need to, like, if you want it to be exactly like mine, you need these flaps as well. But, you know, you can figure it out yourself, guys, as long as it's like 8 inches tall, big enough to fit. I think it's 8.5 inches for a A4 size piece of paper in it. So as long as you've got it, like, the length of it, and what I would do is get, like, the paper you're working on, like, say, an A4, and just cut your cardboard that way, you know, lengthwise, and then just widthwise, obviously, and then put your paper in and kind of measure it that way, or, you know, so you know exactly how much to cut. I know I'm not explaining this very well, but you can figure it out, guys. I'm sure you can. So you just get your cardboard, you fold it in half, cut it, and then if you want these bits, you just get a bigger bit and then cut this side off just to make your flaps, you know. So it's really, I like it. It's a really good thing. I actually got the idea from Jenny Bailey. She motivated me, so that was what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this to store my art pages in, so it's a really good idea. So thanks, Jenny Bailey, for the inspiration. So basically what I have done is I've got my cardboard, obviously, and I'm sorry I'm not explaining very well. I'm just waiting and I'm kind of all over the place. So I've got my napkins. No, I've got my cardboard, and what I did was I just covered it with the backing from napkins. You know, when you separate the napkins, you get the backing. So I covered mine with the napkin. I done like 2 or 3 layers, I think it was. And then I got another napkin, which is this. And one of my friends did a napkin swap with me, and she was nice enough to send me these lovely fairy napkins. So basically that's all I did. I just covered the box with the cardboard with glue, and I just use white school glue because I don't know where. I think it's in the cupboard, and I can't get to it at the moment. So I just used the white school glue and I just covered it again, and I'm going to do it this side actually, and then I'll pause the video, let it dry, and then I'll come back. So it'll only be a few minutes for you, but a lot longer for me. Now I've kept this bit clear, I'm not really fussed about that, so I've kind of kept that bit clear. So basically I just open my bottle, and I hope you can see what I'm doing, guys. I just open my bottle and I kind of pour it on, like that. Right. And just kind of zigzag it. And just pour it on, and then you just get your card or your brush. Sorry about the noise, guys, if it's noisy. Try to do it as quietly as you can. And just spread your glue about. As I say, I'm just doing it with this, but you can do it with a brush or whatever. You just want to kind of make it as even as possible, but it doesn't need to be perfect. And the more wrinkles in your napkins, the better. Your base napkins, you can make wrinkles in your top napkins as well, but your base napkins, you want it to be quite wrinkly when you're putting them on, so that you get texture. So I think that's enough, guys. So then you just kind of measure it up as best you can. Now obviously I'm going to end up with a wee bit of waste here at the end, because I don't want to use a whole napkin. Well, that bit's already covered, so I don't need the whole napkin. And I just kind of press it down like that. Or you can get your brayer and roll it like that. And just kind of make sure it all gets on there. And if it rips, then it's okay, because it gives it more texture. But you just want to kind of press it down and push it down so that... And as I say, sometimes using these brayers can make it rip. And you can put on as many layers of napkins as you like. So the hashtag for this event is #trashtotreasures, I think. So I thought this was ideal for this event, because this is what I've been working on. And I just noticed this morning that I haven't even really been on Facebook, but I noticed this morning that Nikki Parr and Shemi Dixon had done a video for this, and I thought, oh, that's kind of up my alley, and that's kind of what I'm working on at the moment, because it is trash. It is a box, so basically people would usually throw this out, so I thought, well, that's actually quite good for what I'm working on. And now basically all I did with the extra there was fold it over, and I'm trying to find my scissors. I guess I could just do that another layer, couldn't I? Sometimes I just use my fingers to spread as well, and I'm just kind of going over and trying to get these edges down so that I don't need to cut it off and completely waste it. And I've got a little gem in there, just want to go in there, but I don't want it in there yet. So, and if you want, you can put another layer of glue at the top, and I have got a brush here somewhere that I can use to spread, and I just don't know where it is. I don't know where anything is, guys. So I'm just gonna, and this brush isn't the best, but I don't know where all my brushes are either. It's because I need to buy more, because usually, like, I don't really clean them much or anything like that, so it's, I usually buy ones out the dollar store, like these ones, to work with, because that way you don't really need to clean them and all that kind of stuff. If you go hard and done, then it's alright, because you didn't spend a lot of money on them and they can just get thrown out. You know, so I call them reuse it well. What do you call that? Throwaway brushes. So there we go. So now I'll pause this video so you can see here. And I kind of have done the edge, but it's not like fully done. But so this is the way it's going to look when it's all dry and it's back and front. I haven't bothered with the flap because I kind of want to keep the fact that it's cardboard as well. So I'm going to pause the video, guys, and let this dry. It may take an hour or two to dry properly, but I'm happy with that, and I'll just pause the video, go and do what I've got to do, and then I'll come back. Alright, so I'll speak to you in a bit, and I don't know how long this video is going to be. I might actually break it up so that it's not too long, because I think the event lasts for a few days, so it lets me spread it out. So I don't know yet. I'll probably do a short, you know, a couple of short videos and upload them over the next couple of days. So I'll speak to you soon, guys. Hi guys, I'm back. I'm just closing down my internet. So I kind of just put it in front of the fire to kind of dry it. It's not 100% dry, but it'll do for me. So this is the box, front and back, how it looks. Let me see. I can just faintly see the fairies, which I like. I like the fact it's like that. So basically, I'm going to have some fun out decorating. I've got a few bits and bobs that I have, you know, so I'm just going to play. I've not got a plan in mind, but so I'm just going to play the way. If you want to watch me play, then stick around. If not, then there's plenty of other hat. If you just search hashtag, no, like the sign hashtag, and then trash to treasure, I think it's called. And there's plenty of other videos, but I am going to play with this. So basically, I've got some bits and bobs here as well. Some napkin that I've actually put some here as well. I've got some napkin that I have stamped some images on and stuff like that as well. So I'm just going to glue these on, and I'm just going to glue this one on as it is, I think. The images aren't perfect, but I really don't want to do this because then I'm going to wait again to dry it, but hey ho, let's give it a go. So if I need to pause again, I will, but I just want to glue these on. Hopefully it won't take long to glue these and for these to dry. As I say, I'm no too fussed about crinkles. I just want them on here. And I just love the fact that I can just layer. You know, I love layering stuff on to, you know, I love making layers. I'm just hoping that this doesn't take long to dry, guys, so that I'm not having this here for ages, because we're already at 15 minutes and I'm sure that there's plenty of other videos that you want to go and watch. So I'm thinking I'll make this video half an hour long, and as I say, even if you don't want to watch it all right now and you want to go and check out other videos, you can always come back and watch the rest of this video if you like. As I say, I'm not at my greatest, guys, because like I'm just getting back into crafting. I went through a phase where I was kind of losing my mojo, and I wasn't crafting as many of my usual subscribers would know, because like, I've actually had a few people messaging me asking me if I'm okay, because like, I've not done any videos. I know I've done like one or two about my weight loss journey, but I haven't done a crafting video in a long time. It's just one of the ones where I'm just no motivated, and then something like this comes along. Well, as I say, I've kind of been starting this off camera. I started it yesterday, and I haven't been on any, like, keeping up with the CAC group or community. So I'm kind of like, I didn't know about this, because I haven't really been on Facebook much either, so I didn't know about this, and I started this yesterday, and I thought, you know what, when I seen this morning, I was like, hey, time to get a video done, you know. Oh, my phone's going crazy. I hate that when, like, my phone's been off for days, because my phone has been off for days. I've just... I kind of have been on Facebook, but it's only for the chat. I've not been like looking at pages or anything like that. And I've been on like YouTube, but it's just really been, I've been putting the videos on and watching them here and there, but I haven't been like necessarily watching them. I've been more listening to them whilst I've been doing other things. So there we go, that just makes it look even more prettier. I love napkins, I love the fact that they're like, I can't even think of the word, see-through, you know, and you can see through them, and you can just keep adding layers and layers and layers. And I don't know why I'm putting this on, because I don't have any more to put on, I bought this, but this little peacock here that I stamped. So I don't know why I was doing the whole box there, but anyway, that's okay, because it just adds more of a seal to it, so that's alright. So there we go, and that's that. It's just about 17 minutes, I don't know. I have got some little embellishments and stuff like that as well, that I could like kind of glue on here, and I think I will just do that just now, and then the next time I'll come back and we'll probably decorate it, guys, because I'm kind of running low on time. So I'll be right back, I'm just going to grab the bits and bobs that I have, and I'll be right back. Alright guys, I'm back, and I've picked up a few bits and bobs that I have. I'm kind of annoyed at myself, because I've got a bunch of flowers from Little Snippets, and I've been tidying up and I don't know where I've put them, so I'm kind of annoyed, because I would like to use these. I would have liked to have used it on here, you know, but I don't know where I've put them, so. You know what, I'm going to, where are all my paints? Here we go. You know what, I'm not going to glue things on at the moment. I am going to do some painting on this as well. Do some painting and stuff like that. It's still a bit wet actually, so I don't know how well this will work. But I do want to put some paint on here as well. If I can get the paint on. And you know, just to add a bit of colour on here. And I'm not really going for a theme, guys, so this journal cover is going to be a bit of mishmash, because it's going to be like some paper cloud, it's going to really be mixed media. You know, I'm going to do some paint on there, I'm going to put some lace on it, you know, so it's going to really be a mash of items. Hang on a sec, I'll show you. A bit like this page, where it's no got a theme, it's no perfect, and I have made the quote, art doesn't always have to make sense as long as you have fun creating it. And I had lots of fun creating this page. So yeah, I have got a video on that as well, which I'll link in the cards. I'll put it in the cards if you want to check out how I made that video. How I made that page. So I'm just gonna put some gelatos. I don't know how you pronounce it. Oops. Get some paint on there as well. Oops. So I'm just gonna put some of my gelatos on there as well, and I'll clean that off. And I know I've got many wavy weights left. I think this is my last one, so I'm kinda trying to make it last. This is my last baby light, guys. Until I go to the shop and get more. So yeah, I'll just put some gelato on now. And I should have really dried that off, but I'll just clean this off. That's alright. It's okay, easily cleaned. And I should be waiting till each layer is dry though before I do another layer, but as I say, they're easily cleaned. So yeah, it's just going to be a mishmash of colours and stuff like that one. Yeah, it's not going to be perfect. So I want it to really have a mixed media feel about it. I don't know where all my other tomatoes is. Lying around somewhere. I've put them like, I've got a habit of putting things away and then I just don't remember what I've done with them, so I'm just trying to make it look the same front and back. So that's kind of what I'm doing. I'm trying to make it look similar, but not quite, you know what I mean? So just adding some colours on, like, so I'll need to put a bit more on there, I think, because it's there's nowhere near as much paint on here as there is on the front, so I just need to do that, spread it about like that, just to make it have a really, I want it to have like a really arty feeling, you know, an arty look as well. And I don't know what I'm saying that I'm putting laces and that on it. I might not even put laces on it. I might just use it like this and just, you know, I don't know. I'm just playing around, guys. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna do. But some red, maybe some red on here. Get red. Well, yeah, it's red. So I just put some red on, and you're like, "Oh my God, what are you doing? You're covering up all the other stuff." And yeah, I'm a bit. So I'll just try and make this a bit more see-through, so it's not as bad one. And it does look messy, guys. I know it does. You're probably screaming at me going, "You just ruined it." But that is the joys of doing mixed media, you know. It's, you play around and you see what you like. Now, I do kind of like that, actually. It looks kind of cool and you can still see the stamps through it, so I do like that, actually. But it's just experimenting, guys, and seeing what yours like. You might watch this and go, "Oh my God, she's just totally ruined it," but, or some people might go, "Oh, that's cool," you know. It's just, everybody's taste is different. I like messy. I don't like perfect. I like messy. So if I've got to mess this up, then that's what I'm gonna do. Because I do like messy. And it's not exactly muddy, so it's alright. Some bits it looks a wee bit muddy, but to me it looks kinda cool. So I'm going to pause, dry this off, and I'll come back because I've still got 5 minutes left, and I'll come back. So I'll be back in a second and show you what it looks like when it's completely dry. Alright guys, I'm back, and this is how it looks at the moment. So I think it's looking pretty cool. That's the back. I think it is looking pretty cool, but the back needs more stamps, I think. So I am going to... my trousers are falling down. I am going to do a bit of stamping. If I can find my stamps now. Oh, so these were given to me by Nikki Parr, and I really like them. They are doily stamps and stuff like that, so I really like them, and I do tend to use them quite a bit, but my ink is going pretty low. I don't even know if this is going to work, because my ink is pretty... no, and it's not working. Great. I think my ink pad, my Archival ink, has seen its days, guys. I may need to invest in a new one. But I have had this for quite a bit, so... it ain't working. I don't know. Yeah, that's a bit of a bummer. Because... I do like this stamp, but maybe I could, you're probably all screaming, you need to put pressure on the back as well. I know. You know me though, I like doing things the wrong way. So I'm going to try and use some of the distress inks on it, maybe that'll work. Maybe. That will work. I don't know. Probably not though. I think it's because of the box. It's just not working the way I want it to work. I don't know. I just think it's the box itself. It's just not working the way I want it to work. And it's, you know, it's a bit of a bummer. But, you know, I have got black ink there that might work with. I have got some proper black ink here, but I actually think it's just because I'm not putting enough pressure on the box, guys. But if this doesn't work, then it's definitely the pressure, because this stamp pad is really juicy, but it's not Archival. That's the only thing. It's just... nah, it's the box itself. It's not going to work properly with the texture of the box. There's too much texture on there, which is a bit of a bummer, because it is a really pretty stamp. But I suppose if I really want it on there, I can stamp it on the napkin and then glue the napkin on. But I don't know if I really want to. But that might be what I need to do, guys. But maybe even just adding a bit of black here and there will help the back. It doesn't necessarily need to be stamped. But I do want to add some of this distress stuff as well. This was also given to me by Nikki. She's so good to me. So just a wee bit here and there. I really like this. I think some orange as well. Oh, it's tea dye, and some of that in there as well. I just love mixing and testing things out and seeing how they work and how they look together. I just love it. That's what I love about mixed media. Is the fact that it's just, you know, you can just play and test out your stuff. It doesn't necessarily need to be, you know, perfect. It's all about playing, guys. Play with your stuff. Don't just, you know, and I've got a habit of, like, no testing my stuff out and just leaving them lying and, you know, playing with them for ages. And you know, you need to use your stuff up, and that is kind of what I'm trying to do at the moment, because I've not bought any like really craft and stuff in quite some time actually. Since I got my big shot, I've not been buying crafting items. I have been spending quite a bit on games though, computer games, which is probably quite bad because I sat and worked it out the other day exactly how much I spent on the game The Sims, and yeah, it is quite a lot, but it's, you know, I'm using it, so it's no as if I'm wasting the money and not using the game. I have been playing it, in fact I've been playing it quite a lot lately, and that's why that is why I am no crafting as much, because I'm too busy playing that. But oh well, it's making me happy. So this is what we have so far, guys. Just I'm trying to do it so you can see. This is what we have so far. Just here's the front, there's the back, and these are probably going. That just looks a complete mess. But when you think about it, this is only the background, so I'll be adding like die cut shapes, scraps of paper and stuff like that on here as well, so you need to think it that way. But this is only day one and this is the background. So I might actually upload this and then do another video and upload another video today, I don't know. I'll do this and then I'll work on one and upload that tomorrow. And so if you like this video, guys, I'm sorry if it's been a bit boring for you, but I hope it does give you some inspiration and you know, reuse your cardboard, use it as a journal cover thing to put your loose journals in, loose journal pages. It's handy as well if you don't have like a ring binder, because most people do have cardboard lying around. So I like the idea, because if you don't have like a ring binder, or you know, you don't have the proper material to make a big journal like this, because like a lot of people do it loose and then they bind it all together. If you don't have the materials to bind it all together, it's handy just putting it in here. And it, as I say, it just sits in there like that. And you just tuck it in and it'll just sit in there like that. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do in these bits yet. I'll probably do this off camera. I'll probably just paint them. I was saying that I'm going to put lace and that on here, but I don't think I will, because I don't know. Because if I'm lying it flat, I kind of want it flat. So I don't know yet, but I may put some bling in that on it, but I don't know about laces. And it's too grungy, I think, to put laces on. So, yeah. But it is good, you know, you just put your wee pages in there and you have a nice... But anyway, guys, I'm going to go now and I will record another part of this to upload tomorrow. So if you do like the video and it wasn't too boring for you, come back and check out tomorrow, because I will be uploading another video tomorrow. And if you do like the video, please give it a thumbs up so I know you do like it. If you haven't subbed, if you like, check my channel out, check my other videos out, see what you think. If you like it, then give me a sub, please. And you're more than welcome as well to give me a comment with some feedback, what you think maybe I should do next, if you have got any more ideas, and you know, feedback is always welcomed. But anyway, guys, I will speak to you soon. Bye for now. Thanks for watching.